What's up, YouTube? So it seems this was a poison ivy plant that got touched. So it all happened 14 days ago, 2 weeks ago, and it developed in staged and ultimately, and this is perhaps the reason I'm doing this video, I went to the ER yesterday night, and they say that it's infected. It's a super infection actually. This is, if you don't treat it, it's life-threatening. So if you don't go antibiotics quickly, it will spread to your body. Then you got septic infection into your whole body, and imagine the rest. So it was really by the steps, and notice how badly this well here. I look like a hobbit or something. It happened in steps, so I'll put you a few pictures. With the development, with the days that came, that went on. And I think the problem is that at first you got those bumps, red dots. You may also got blisters if you have long pants. So try not to wear long pants if it's possible, or at least maybe get some one of these leggings, you know, like woman wear, something sticking on your leg, and then the pants over it so it doesn't rub against the skin. That's the worst. But even so, you are going to rub during your sleep, and it's the sleep that is really miserable because you cannot sleep on this side. Perhaps it depends where you got touch contaminated. You need to sleep on the other side on your back. It's difficult. But what happens once you rub it, you get these blisters, and the blisters means you have open skin. And when I was sleeping the day or the night before, it got swollen like this. I was staying on that side in my sleep. I just cannot control that. And the pressure from the bed, when open wounds, it got the infection started. It got the bacteria from the skin. There's always bacteria inside your skin, but it's not warming you, hurting you normally. But when you have this infection, the bacteria goes inside, underneath the skin, and starts the infection because I was sleeping on that side. So that's something to worry about. Anyhow, also just because you see this rash here, it started to come to appear maybe 12 days after this area here and this area here. This one was older, so it's really keeps appearing. But I was saying, just because we are there, the moment you see a swelling and some kind of redness, this one is really intense. But even lighter redness or any kind of swelling, go right to the ER. Do not wait. You need to get antibiotics. And by the way, this the foot actually did swell in about 20 minutes, so it was really, really fast. I was saying, if you ever happen to have dogs or cats, do not ever let them lick the wound. Dogs and cats have one of the worst bacteria in their mouth. And you get, I didn't, that's not my citation, I'm just adding this to the video. If you happen to have dogs, cats, you get a really terrible infection from dogs, cats, and it can literally not just kill you, but you can get amputated. Just check out Google up images to see what I'm talking about. Anyhow, that's just a warning. But yes, this thing gets ugly even. So right now I'm about 15 days into it from the moment I got contaminated. For the 4 days, first 4 days had nothing. After the 4 days, started to have white red dots. They keep appearing through the days until 10 days after the contamination. So for about 1 week, I could see new dots appearing, and this is why they or everybody at the yard told me, oh, this is poison ivy. So the dots keep appearing. It's really weird. And after about, I'd say 12 days, one morning I noticed the swelling, and the same day in the afternoon my foot started to swell within 20-30 minutes, not more than that. Just really got really bad, and that's when I rushed to the ER. These plants have oil on them. Sorry, there's a daycare nearby, so they have oils on them, and usually you will just touch an area with the oil, and then you, without knowing, you spread that oil everywhere else. So you need to wash every single cloth of yours The worst is to touch your mouth, inside your mouth, or your eyes, or other, you know, genitalia, stuff like that, because especially in your mouth, you also have bacteria, strong bacteria in your mouth. Yes, believe it or not, just Google up. And if you have wounds in your mouth, then you can get a really bad infection, eyes as well. But I was saying that while you can wash it with alcohol, you can rub the area with alcohol, wash your hands. Also, you can wash your clothes with soap, it should go away. But it's that oil that you spread, you don't know. For 3-4 days later, you start having that rash that at the first I thought I had bed bugs. It really looks like bed bugs. I'll show you in a moment. Okay, let's show a few pics and gives you an idea how this evolved to this point. Right now I'm on antibiotics, I'm on anti-inflammatory corticosteroids by mouth because they are stronger, and also I'm on a I have a cream, antibiotic cream, which I need to spread over. All right, so really take care of this, do not let it go bad, go to the ER, get antibiotics. Thanks. Oh yes, it's itching very, very strongly. You absolutely need to restrain from itching. It's, it gets you into another level of problems, and like I said, the nights are going to be really tough. Very little sleep.